You're listening to the audio production of Staying in Love, Audio Bible Studies by Andy Stanley, published by Zondervan and presented by the author. These audio Bible studies are a unique learning experience. Unlike a traditional audiobook's direct narration of a book's text, Staying in Love includes high-quality live recordings that cover the important points from each chapter as well as relevant material from other sources.
Now, we need to spend about 10 seconds talking about falling in love, and that's all it really requires is 10 seconds. Because the only requirement for falling in love is a pulse, right? I mean, if you have a pulse, you can fall in love. Some of you are in love with people you've never met. They're on TV, and you're just in love. You just stare at them. You think, I'm so in love with him. I'm so in love with her. I mean, you know, she reads the news, and you're in love with her. You know. So it just doesn't, in fact, as we've already talked about, there are 1,500 organizations in this country, 1,500, that if you pay them your money and give them a profile, they will connect you with somebody with a similar profile. It is, and you may not believe this, it has never been easier to fall in love. It has never been easier to connect with a broader number of people because of media and because of social networking. It has never been easier to fall in love, but I would argue, and I bet you would agree, it's never been more difficult to stay in love. And yet that's what we want. And we somehow think it's possible. And we keep looking around thinking maybe we're going to find the one. Because there's something in you and there's something in me that wants to finish life and do life with that special someone. We don't want to just be in a relationship. We don't want to just survive the years. We want to be in love. But it's getting more and more difficult. And there's several reasons why it's so difficult. And none of this is new information. Part of it's what you saw growing up, right? Part of it's what you experienced. The truth is, very few people have ever been around a healthy, romantic, you know, marriage couple relationship. Most people have never seen one. I mean, seen one like tracked with it over a period of years, having grown up in a home where your parents, you know, were on the same page and had the kind of relationship you wanted to have one day. Very few people have ever even seen it. So consequently, what's modeled for us and the law of relationship and the rules of relationship are so wrong, and yet they're the very ones we adopt, that it makes it almost impossible for us to stay in love. I mean, here's what a lot of you, a lot of us grew up with: do unto others as they deserve to be done unto, right? Do unto others as they do unto you. Isn't that it? Do unto others as your mood would have it. Do unto others so as to get them to see things your way. Do unto others until you wear them down and get your way. Do unto others until you're ready to leave. I mean, as you think about the relationships you've tracked with either your friends in the office or your cousins or maybe even your parents, or, you know, when we look at relationships, you know, people may stay together, but they're not in love, you assume. They're not what you want. There's just kind of surviving if they even stay together at all. So consequently, because of what most of us see growing up, and what most of us have had modeled for us, I mean, we're just completely ill-equipped. We've never seen one. And yet, all of us think one's possible, and we think we're candidates for that kind of relationship. The other thing that makes it difficult is what we felt growing up. Now, a bunch of smart guys got together, men and women actually, and they came up with a list. This is kind of overwhelming. A list of what it takes for a child to grow up in a very, very nurturing environment and to leave adolescence and to be equipped to engage in healthy relationships in the future. In other words, here's what it would take to be fully emotionally, and in two weeks we're going to talk about emotions specifically, so hang in there. To be emotionally equipped to engage in long-term relationship, here's all it takes. You need to grow up in a home where you get respect, and this is like massive doses of all of this. Respect, encouragement, comfort, security, support, acceptance, approval, appreciation, attention, and affection. Sounds like the family you grew up in, doesn't it? You get constant respect, encouragement, comfort, security. Everybody's there, nobody's leaving. Support, acceptance, approval, appreciation, attention, and affection. Now, if that's what it takes over a long period of time to equip us to engage in long-term relationships as an adult, I mean, if that's what we need to have felt growing up, I mean, what are the odds of us being able to maintain a forever and happily ever after kind of relationship, especially when we connect with and meet people who didn't grow up getting that kind of stuff either? So consequently, what happens for most of us is we come into adulthood looking for someone from which we can get respect, encouragement, comfort, security, support, acceptance, approval, appreciation, attention, and affection. And I fall in love with you, but now that we're both in love with each other, I'm wondering, are you going to give me respect, encouragement, comfort, security, support, acceptance, approval, appreciation, attention, and affection, or are you just cute? Or do you just have a good job? Because once we're in love with each other, what begins as a hug around the neck becomes a stranglehold. Give me affection, comfort, security, love. You know, I got to have it. Because I came into this thing with a deficit, you know. I've been malnutritioned in terms of love and affection and all that stuff. And I'm going to squeeze it out of you, and you're going to squeeze it out of me. And I just wonder why I don't think you're so cute anymore. And that car, so what, you know? And all of a sudden, the things that just, you know, created this emotional energy where we couldn't stay away from each other, somehow it starts to go away. Part of what makes it so hard is what we have felt and haven't felt. And here's just a disturbing statistic. And this has been true for years. This is this year's statistic, but it's been this way for years. 40% of the children born in this country this year will be born into homes where there's no dad. 40%. There will be no stable male influence at all. 40%. Now, we can argue all day long about single moms and nurturing and all that stuff, and I'm not here to try to make a statement. I'm just telling you. If it takes all of that to equip someone to engage relationally and stay engaged relationally and be a healthy relationship, and 40% of the babies born in our country will never have a meaningful relationship with their father at all, I'm just telling you, they're gonna struggle. There's a deficit, and it's not their fault any more than it's probably your fault. But it's the reality. And yet, you're equipped to fall in love. But I think in terms of what's been modeled and what we have felt, many of us are not equipped to stay in love. And then there's another thing that makes this really, really difficult. Our culture, and you know this, none of this is new information, our culture has a really low threshold of pain relationally, a really low relational threshold for pain, of pain, which means it doesn't have to hurt too bad, and we just decide to get out, right? Gone are the days where I said I do, and I do means I do, and I'm going to keep doing whether I like it or not, and whether she or he likes it or not, we're just doing. We do. That's what we do. That day's gone, right? That it just doesn't take a lot of pain. And plus, in our culture, the message you and I get every single day, and maybe this, you think this is true, and you know, we can talk about that later. The message we get every single day is if you're not happy in your current relationship, it's because you're with the wrong person. You chose poorly. You need to re-choose. You need to reboot. You need to get out. You need to start over because you chose poorly. And if you'll just keep looking, you'll find that soulmate. And if you'll keep moving from relationship to relationship, eventually it's going to happen to you because you're finally going to meet the right person. But if you talk to people who've been married 20 years plus, who are still in love, and ask them about that approach, they will tell you there were times along the way these 20 years that I wondered if I had the right person. But I decided that the person I chose was going to be the right person. And we're so glad we worked through those difficulties. Because choosing the right person is part of it. But learning to be and to become the right person is the other part of it. And it's the
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.